Zeal Education Society, redefining excellence.
Welcome back. In the previous 3 to 4 lectures, we have seen or we have taken a review of Z transform, inverse Z transform, and then its application for solving the difference equation. Today we will take one step ahead and we will see the concept of pulse transfer function, which is analogous to the concept of transfer function, which is applicable for the continuous time system. So let us consider a system with impulse response g of k. So this is a discrete time system. So it is producing output y of k upon applying input r of k. Now this output y of k can be obtained if r of k and g of k are known, and that is by convolution. So output y of k is the convolution of r of k and g of k, and hence y of k is given as summation I equal to 0 to infinity. We are considering unilateral sequences or causal sequences, so this is starting from 0 to infinity, r of I into g of k minus I. Now by convolution property of Z transform, we get, if we apply it here, we get y of z equal to r of z into g of z, and then I get g of z equal to y of z by r of z, where y of z and r of z are the z transform of y of k and r of k, while g of z is z transform of system impulse response g of k. Now in this case, whenever we are applying this convolution sum, it is applicable only for linear time invariant systems, and it considers that system is initially relaxed. And that means what I can say here, in this case g of z is equal to y of z with r of, by r of z with zero initial conditions. So I can say here that it is with zero initial conditions, and then g of z is called as pulse transfer function of the discrete time system or digital system or sample data system. And here it can be defined as, let us define it, pulse transfer function. So it is defined as ratio of z transform of output to Z transform of input with zero initial conditions. So I rewrite it. PTF is equal to, in this case it's Z of Z equal to Y of Z by R of Z with zero initial conditions. And it is in Z transform pair with impulse response. That means if you take Z transform of impulse response, you get pulse transfer function, and if you take inverse Z transform of pulse transfer function, you will get impulse response of the system. Now here we have considered directly a discrete time or digital system, and we have defined the pulse transfer function. But whenever we consider a sample data control system, it consists of particularly only one digital control or digital block, that is a controller, and the remaining blocks or remaining subsystems are continuous in time. Along with this, it also includes some sampler and hold devices. So in that case, if you want to find out the pulse transfer function of overall system, which is used to analyze the system, we must revisit the relation between Laplace transform, star Laplace transform and Z transform. So let's do it. So I will call it as revisiting. We have already done this, revisiting Laplace transform, star Laplace transform and Z transform. So let us consider a signal, say x of t is a signal and it is a sampled now with sampling rate t. Then this particular thing is called as x star t or x star kt, and this is also called as x of kt. Now this is a discrete time signal, this is a sampled version, they are the same, but this one is used for star Laplace and this one is used for the Z transform. So this is same as, I can say, x star kt, and this is also, say, also you can say this as x of k. Nomenclature, I am saying just nomenclature. And now let me define the x of s, Laplace transform. Laplace transform x of s, it is unilateral, I am considering unilateral, so integration will be from 0 to infinity x of t e raised to minus st dt. Now when I sample this x of t, this becomes x star t, and as it is sampled, this integration becomes summation and t becomes t equal to kt. So x star s is equal to this, I will call star Laplace transform, it is summation k equal to 0 to infinity. You can call this as x star t or x of kt. So this is x of kt e raised to minus s kt finish. So this is nothing but sampled version of Laplace transform. And then finally the Z transform. Z transform is given by x of z is equal to summation k equal to 0 to infinity x of kt or x of k z raised to minus k. So if I put z equal to e raised to st in star Laplace transform, I get z transform, and hence properties of z transform and properties of star Laplace transform are identical. Now, whenever you have some samplers and whole devices, some continuous time system or some digital systems in an overall system, we are required to use the properties of the star Laplace transform to solve the block diagram. So let us take some important properties of star Laplace transform. So I start with very basic thing, that is, if I have a signal in, I do everything in S domain. So if this signal x of s is star, means sampled, it is equal to x star s. Now I have a sampled version itself and I resample it. So it will be star of x star. So it is same as x star. Then the third one, if I have say x1 of s plus or minus x2 of s and its star, then it is equal to x1 star s minus plus or minus x2 star s. So both the terms can be separated and then take u star. Then the fourth one, let I have x1 of s into x2 of s and its star, and then it is equal to x1 x2 star s. So first you have to multiply the two terms and then you have to take star. Now if I have one term as x1 star s into x2 of s and then taken star, then what about this? This is equal to x1 star s into x2 star s separately. So, and even we can take one more, actually it is not required, it is covered here. So if both are star and if it is a star, it will be same as this one. So these five properties are required while solving the sample data control systems. So now what we will do, we will take some cases separately. How to resolve the cases, let us see. Pulse transfer function of two blocks in series. Now in this case there are two cases. Case number one, the blocks are separated by a sampler. Now let us consider this case. So in this case what we will do, we will consider one block. This is a continuous time system having transfer function g1 of s. Applied input is R of s. Then there is another block. Again, this is a continuous time system with transfer function g2 of s, and then we get the output y of s. And what we have to find here? The pulse transfer function y of z by R of z. Now here what we have, I have said the two blocks are separated by a sampler and are in series. Kausad, I will write it here, blocks in series. So, here these two are the blocks in series and separated by a sampler, and we have to find out y of z by r of z. So how to do it? Let us see one by one. What we have, we will make this as set w of s. Additional variable we will assign. Now what I have is, this is r of s, so after sampler it becomes r star s. So what I get here is w s is equal to g1 of s into r star s. No doubt this will be w star s after sampler. Whenever you put a sampler, the signal becomes its starved version or sampled version. So then, if I take star of this, now let us use the property. So I will make here taking star Laplace transform, we get, what do we get? W star s is equal to g1 of s into r star s whole star. So now making use of the property that here one of the signal is already starred. So this will be what? G1 star s r star s. Next we have also y of s. What is y of s? G2 of s into w star s, which is equal to g2 of s into g1 star s into r star s. Then taking star Laplace, this will be what? Y star s. And it will be star Laplace of this. So it will be star Laplace of g2 of s g1 star s into r star s and whole star. That is equal to g2 star s g1 star s r star s. Because already these two are separated and they are starred in the starred form, only this is not in the starred form, so it will be in multiplication. And then what I will do, I will take z transform. So z and Laplace are in the same form, just what we have to do, y star s shall be replaced with y of z, g1 star s will be g1z, g2 star s will be g2z, r star s will be r of z, and then pulse transfer function y of z by r of z is g1z into g2z. So what it implies that, what is g1 of z? G1 of z is z transform of g1 of s. What is g2 of z? G2 of z is z transform of g2 of s. And the two z blocks are in continuous time domain in represented in their S form or Laplace transform function. First take their z transform and then multiply it. Now what we will do, we will take the second case. That is case 2. So what is the case 2? Case 2, again two blocks in series, but the blocks are not separated by a sampler. So they are not separated by a sampler. Means how are they? G1 of S, G2 of S, and then Y of S, and this is R of S. So as convention, here we have a sample. Okay, so no doubt this will be R star S. And now let us do the same treatment. Here what I have, y of s is equal to R star S into G1 of S into G2 of S. Then taking standard Laplace, we are doing it first or second time, so we are doing in a very elaborative manner, but later on we will do it directly. Y star S will be what? It will be R star S, G1 of S, G2 of S whole star, and that is equal to, R is already starred, but G1 and G2 are not starred, so first they will be coupled and then starred. So it will be R star S, G1, G2 star S. What does it mean? We will see it later on. But here we have this Y star S, and now taking Z transform. In Z transform, what we have, just we have to replace star Laplace with Z. So it will be R of Z and G1, G2, Z. And that means pulse transfer function in this case is Y of Z upon R of Z, which is equal to G1, G2, Z. And this is not equal to G1, Z into G2, Z, because what it is? This G1, G2, Z means first we have to take multiplication of G1 with G2 and then take Z. That means I have to make here a note. G1 of Z into G2 of Z is not equal to G1, G2, Z. So we have done it through a classical way or using first principles. So first the term is given in Laplace, we convert it into star Laplace, and then we took the Z transform. Now what we will do now, we will make use of this and we will take one closed loop system and we will find out the pulse transfer function of a closed loop system. Pulse transfer function of a closed loop system. What I will do, I will take a generalized example and later on we will solve the examples in number. Y of S, R of S, and what is our objective? We have to find out the pulse transfer function. So what I will do here, I will assign some variables. I will assign the variables like, say, let this be B of S and let this be E of S, and obviously then it is star, so this will be E star S, and now I will find out its pulse transfer function. So what I will do here, first I will write down the expression for, so what we have E of S is equal to R of S minus B of S. Correct. This is a very classical procedure to obtain the Pulse Transfer Function of closed loop system. Then taking TARD Laplace transform. Let us make the use of that addition subtraction property. So they are already separated. So E star S will be what? Now I will write directly R star A minus B star S. Actually it is R of S minus B of S whole star. So by using that property we make it R star S minus B star S. And then taking Z transform, immediately I will take Z transform. I get E of Z is equal to R of Z minus B of Z, and that gives me R of Z is equal to E of Z plus B of Z. Now let me call this as equation number 1. Now what I will do, my prime objective is to find out Y of Z by R of Z. Now I have got some expression for R of Z, now let me get the expression for Y of Z. So Y of S is what? Y of S is here, so it is E star into G. So E star S into G of S. And then taking star Laplace transform. So taking star Laplace transform, what we get? If I take star here, this will become Y star S and this will be E star S into G star S. We have eliminated one redundant step. Directly I know, if these two are in series, they are already separated by a star, they will be separated by a star even after taking the star Laplace transform. And then taking Z transform, what I get? Taking Z transform. What I get? Y of Z equal to E of Z into G of Z. Okay. Now can I take Y of Z by R of Z directly? Can I get something? No, it is not possible, because again here is another variable B of Z, which is another auxiliary variable. So now we have to find out the equation for B of Z. Okay, we will do that. So what we have B of S is, now while doing this we can take here Y of S, star of Y of S into H of S, but this is not the appropriate way. Appropriate way is we will start with this point E star. So what it is? B star S is E star S into G of S, the signal is here, and then it is star into star and into H of S. And what is it then? It is equal to, if I take the star, it is E star S G of G star S into H of S. And then what is B star S? So taking star Laplace transform, we get B star S is equal to E star already separated, G star already separated, so separation is already done into A star S. And then taking Z transform, it will be resulting into B of Z equal to E of Z, G of Z, H of Z. And then I will mark this as 3. So from 1 and 3, R of Z is equal to E of Z plus E of Z, G of Z, H of Z. So Pulse Transfer Function y of z by r of z is equal to e of z g of z upon e of z into bracket 1 plus g z h z, and that is equal to g of z upon 1 plus g z h z. Now what if we remove this sampler, what will happen? If you remove this sampler, then the same will be g of z upon 1 plus g h z instead of g z h z. So in practice, this is we have done classically, but we can just looking at the block diagram, we can do this. So here how to do this, see, y of z by r of z in a closed loop system or a feedback system is that for getting numerator, we have to move in this direction. So this is a single block, g of s, so this becomes gz, g of z. Then in the denominator, 1 plus, why plus? Because here we have negative feedback. If the feedback is positive, this becomes negative. So 1 plus, again you come like this, g of z, a sampler, that is separation, h of z. So 1 plus g of z, h of z. So if sampler is not there, then the two blocks will not be separated, and then it will be gz upon 1 plus ghz. So here we have laid down some foundation. We have considered all the three possible cases. Addition of signal, multiplication of two blocks in series, separated by a sampler and not separated by a sampler, and also a feedback loop. In the next class, we will solve some examples for finding out the pulse transfer function of the given block diagrams.